Hello everyone, I'm Mrs. L. Karthiyaini, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of English, Arulmigu Palaniyandavar Arts College for Women, Palani, Dindukal District. I'm here to give a short introduction about eco-literature. Literature mingled along with ecology, and I'm here to give short instances as well. The paper Eco-Literature is prescribed for the 3rd BA English students. Ecology. The term ecology relates to the surrounding environment as well as the biosphere. The biosphere is the surface of the earth where soil, water, and air combine together to sustain life. Life is possible only in this zone. The living organisms in this zone range from the microorganisms like fungi, bacteria, to the largest animals, including human beings. As a result of this, it plays a very crucial role in the maintenance of the ecosystems, that is, the existence of the particular species in this particular living world and their reciprocal interactions. So, a biosphere constitutes to the survival of an ecosystem, and the environment which includes the biosphere is related together, and this forms the basis of ecology. So, from this we can understand that ecology is nothing but a combination of our environment as well as the biosphere, which includes all organisms. Okay, eco-literature. So it is a recent trending topic in literature. And what does this say about? In general, literature is a reflection of human life. Literature is nothing but a reflection of human life. And what do this literature do? What is the purpose of literature in human life? Literature. The word literature means a representation of human life. Literature is nothing but is a kind of reflection of the human feelings and emotions. Concisely, literature is like a child which replicates what we throw to it. If we throw some happiness, it gives back. And if we throw sadness, the same is given back to us. So similarly, literature throws a highlight on ecology, the environment in which the human beings live. And this ecological literature is meant by the word nature, whether the examination of place may be different, and it examines the human perception of wilderness, how people have changed throughout history, whether the current environmental issues are mentioned or it is taken into consideration or not. And even some popular culture also takes into consideration that this ecology or ecosystem must be given some focus. Because of this, recently many writers have changed their attention towards ecology or environment. The ecologically minded individuals and many scholars are publishing more progressive works of eco-theory and eco-criticism even ever after the explosion of environmentalism in the late 1960s and 1970s. So as related to this, one particular work I bring to notice is that by Raymond Williams, and the work is The Country and the City. It is a critique of pastoral literature This work was written in 1973. Apart from this, ecology does not relate to the land alone. It also relates with marine ecology, marine ecological system also. So what we must do, what is the responsibility of each and every human being, is that we should take care of each and every organisms surrounding us. And I give here two examples where the writers focus upon the marine ecology. So, giving consideration not only to the land ecosystem but also the marine ecosystem, where we should give more protection and consider the complete environment as one among us. One is Coromandel Fishers, written by the famous Indian poetess Sarojini Naidu. It deals with the life of, the strugglesome life of the fishermen whose routine work is going for fishing in the daytime and coming back invariable of time. They don't have this particular time or time consciousness to come back to their places. They fish even though there are violent storms. They don't consider, they just ignore the environmental conditions, but they worship the sea goddess as the prime force. The fishermen, the place of fishermen are completely surrounded with fragrant smelling coconut trees and mango trees, and the shades given by those trees are really a kind of positivity to those fishermen, because it gives a positive spirit that every day is a new beginning. Similarly, one more writer from America, the American novelist Ernest Hemingway, has written a novel named The Old Man and the Sea. It is also dealing with the marine ecology. It is a story of an old man, a struggle between the seasoned fishermen, and how much struggle and painstaking efforts he has made to catch a single fish throughout his life. He goes for the main catch, Santiago, and he goes for fishing nearly for 84 days and returns empty-handed. But on his expedition, over the 85th day, he catches a big fish named marlin. And the marlin he caught couldn't be retrieved back to the shore after 3 days because he has very minimal supply of fishing equipments, and this insufficiency made him to return to the shore only with the skeleton of the marlin. But the 3 days course in the sea, the expedition in the sea, gave him a lot of experiences. He considered each and every bird flying over his head as his own brothers. He sees the distant waters and considers as his own breath. So all the complete environment in the sea makes him so flabby, and he is completely happy with what he has. These two instances from literature gives us a lesson that whatever struggle we may face, but we should always maintain the positivity in our life. Really, it's a very big lesson to us from the environment. How one should preserve our environment, the ecology. Ecology doesn't simply mean the living system around us, but also each and every microorganisms living in marine area also, and even in the air. So it is a responsibility of every human being to preserve our environment in the safest part. Thank you.